In this video, we learned how to set up Cinemachine 2D follow camera and how to fix common problems, like jerky camera movements. With Cinemachine, we create virtual cameras that can follow the player. To use Cinemachine, we need to go to the Package Manager. In Unity Registry, search Cinemachine. I will install Cinemachine version 2.6.4. At this time, it's the latest verified version. Now you should see Cinemachine in Unity Editor. If you don't see it, probably you are using a newer version. So you need to right-click in the inspector and you will see Cinemachine. As you can see, we have many different cameras that we can create. Of course, we need a 2D camera. This will create a virtual camera in the scene. Also, on the main camera, Unity will add the Cinemachine brain component. It's the main part of the Cinemachine, and virtual cameras need this brain to function. Let's select the VCam 1. First, we need to set follow target, what this camera needs to follow. That is the player. Now you can see in the game window red and blue zones with some lines. For now, we can disable those. Press play and you will see that the camera follows the player. Of course, we can change the settings and behavior of the camera. Under lens, you should see orthographic size. I will set it to 5. Let's take a look at body section and options. The body section defines how the camera will follow the player. Default body type is framing transposer. You can check other types, but I think that this has the best options. Then we can click on save during play. This will save changes from the camera even in the play mode. The first option is look ahead time. When the player moves, the camera will try to be ahead of the player. But you can see that the camera behaves a bit glitchy. You can use smoothing effect to improve behavior. However, this will not solve the problem completely. The camera is still jerky a bit. You will see it on your screen. I will show you a quick fix and what you need to change in the settings, but first let's see more possibilities. Next is damping. We have a slider for each axis. Damping determines how responsible is the camera. In other words, how fast will follow the player. If we increase X damping, you can see that the camera will slowly go to the position of the player. Sometimes it can be useful for the y-axis when the player jumps. You can get a smoother effect. But you can see similar problems as in the look ahead option. It looks glitchy. To fix that, let's exit the play mode and select the player. Under rigid body settings, you should find interpolation. In short words, interpolation is used to smooth camera movement and eliminate jerky behavior. We have two options, interpolate and extrapolate. If you read documentation, you will find out that interpolate is smoothing based on the previous frame and extrapolate on the next frame. Later, we can have some problems on the moving platform if we use interpolate, so choose the extrapolate option. Now you can use look ahead and damping options as you like. You will not have jerky camera movements. Let's try it with interpolation. You can see it's way better and smooth, with no jerky movements. Next, we choose the position of the camera in regard to the player. Maybe you have seen games where you go just to the right, like Super Mario. Then you set screen X like this. For this game, let's move the camera up, so that player sees more to up than down. Now the player is not in central position, but it's common for platformers to have that kind of setting. Then we have dead zones. For this, we need lines from the beginning. Enable them. Let me just increase dead zones. The camera will not move until the player exits the dead zone. I can move, but the camera is not moving. When I go to the edge of the dead zone, the camera will start to move. The soft zone is more for 3D games. You can play with the settings, maybe try another body type and so on. Just for the information, on the main camera in Cinemachine Brain is one important setting. It's update method. It determines how the camera updates. The smart update is a default method. It will try to use the best update option for each object separately. Fixed update mode is when you move all objects in the fixed update. The smart update is usually the best option, but there is no rule to this. You need to try and see what is the best method for your project. Sometimes it can be a late update. Now you know Cine Machine basics. Thank you for watching and see you next week.